What are you gonna do?
So we've been talking in this series about what are you gonna do? I want you to know that one of the things I'm most grateful for is that our founder, Everett Swanson, chose to do something really important when he chose to focus the ministry of compassion on children, these tiny little ones, often the ones that are the weakest, the poorest, often at the end of the line, and yet scriptures make it very clear, not only loved by God, but respected by God and used by God very, very powerfully sometimes. All through scriptures, almost every time you spot a child, God is doing something pretty important, something that maybe a grown-up couldn't do. I don't know, we know too much, or we think too much, or probably we think we know too much. At any rate, when something really important needs to be done, God often chooses a child, like when a giant needs to be killed, or one of his leaders as a baby in an ark of bulrushes needs to be rescued, or when a king needs to be told, jump in the river if you want to be healed, or when an 8-year-old king needs to arise and be a righteous king, or when a 12-year-old teaches in the temple, or when 5,000 people need to be fed, or when a little unborn baby named John the Baptist jumps for joy in the presence of his Messiah, also an unborn little baby. All through scripture, children are very, very important. But it wasn't just a long time ago, it's today. God uses children powerfully today. Let me tell you one of the stories that I know of how powerfully God uses children. It comes out of Ecuador. A few years ago, the Korean board of directors was visiting Ecuador. They traveled all the way across the world to visit the work in Ecuador. And when they arrived, the pastor of the little project that they were going to visit met their van, and he had a distraught look on his face. And when they said, what's the problem? He said, I know that you've come all the way across the world to see what we do in the lives of children in our project here in my little church, but there's been a tragedy in our church, and tomorrow we're not going to be doing our normal activities that you have come to see. And they said, well, what happened? And he explained that two of the little boys in the project the day before had been crossing a very, very busy street, an 8-year-old and a 6-year-old brothers. And they'd gotten hit by a great big truck in the middle of the traffic. The 8-year-old was very seriously injured and was in intensive care in the hospital. But the little 6-year-old had been killed. And he said, tomorrow is the little 6-year-old's funeral. And he says, there won't be very many children there because in our culture, children don't come to events like this. We try to protect them from this kind of tragedy. The Korean pastors put their heads together and said, you know, we know something about tragedy. We know something about suffering. Why don't we come and just attend the funeral service and suffer with you, our brothers and sisters in Christ? So the next morning, they arrived at this little church. And the church was filled with the normal people of the church. But also there were many children in there. 60 children were in that church. And as they drove up, the pastor was standing in the doorway and he shrugged his shoulders as if to say, I don't know what's happened here. This is not what normally happens. So they went into the church, and there were a few minutes before the service started. And our staff began to talk to some of the 60 children who had gathered. And the question was, what are you doing here? Why have you come to this? And one by one, the children told their stories. They said, this little 6-year-old, he's the one who told me about Jesus. He's the one who prayed with me to accept Jesus into my heart. I owe him everything. And so I've come to his service because I want to send him off to his heavenly Father with all the love that I have in my heart. A little 6-year-old led 50 people to Christ. He had achieved his full life purpose by the tender age of 6. God not only loves children, he believes in children. He used children all through scriptures. He's still using them today. And what are we going to do? We're going to stay faithful to that calling. We are going to release children from poverty in Jesus' name because they will also be a strategic force for the good of the kingdom in the future. That's what we're going to do.
What are you gonna do?